This is CHS TV News.
Good morning, Cathedral. I'm Zoe.
And I'm Keegan with your morning announcements for Tuesday, May 16th.
Let's start off the show with a message from Mr. Daly.
Good morning, Cathedral. So I've got a bunch of thank yous and acknowledgments today on this fine, beautiful Tuesday as we approach summer. So I want to thank our senior boys soccer team. They had a very, very competitive season, and we had a host of volunteer coaches. One, a graduate of the school, Mr. Francesco D'Ambrosio, who I know kind of was the head coach. But we also thank Mr. Gravino, Mr. Caruso, and Mr. Fortino. And the boys had a very competitive season, which ended last week, but we thank them for representing our school in such a fine fashion. Our badminton teams have had such great success, and again, we advanced. I think we won the double championship senior and junior, and we give all the credit to those fine athletes who took our badminton team. We've become a badminton power in the last couple years, and we thank Mr. Ken John, our substitute vice principal, who's been volunteering with that team even when he wasn't working here, and Mr. Stokel and everyone else who helped with the badminton team. And I think putting Gael at the door of the gym when everyone walked in and having all the other schools be terrified of him, even though we love Gael and he's one of the nicest students who's ever come to Cathedral, I think that may have played a part in our success as well. But congratulations to all those badminton players and for the championship that we won. Our senior girls soccer team won the quarterfinal last week against BT in dramatic fashion in overtime with a goal from Nicole Daly. So I know they're in tough today at 2 p.m. in the semifinal at St. Thomas More, but we thank the girls, again, a competitive team who's advanced through the first round of the playoffs, and we thank Mrs. Daly and Miss Aldred for their coaching and wish the girls well today at 2 p.m. at St. Thomas More. And I know the yearbooks came out yesterday, and that is an enormous amount of work that gets done by staff and students. And I have to thank Mr. Tribuco and Ms. DiGregorio, who are the staff members who do most of the work with that. But I know there's a lot of people who contribute, and there's also student editors. And it's such an important document that you wanna make sure you hold on to, students, because someday you'll look back on that book and it's like, it's a historical document of who was at the school, and you'll see the pictures and memories of a time long ago. So thank you very much to everyone who put the yearbook together. And of course, there's a big amount of work that gets done in the main office trying to receive and distribute those things along with the custodians. We have our graduates masked today, and what that is there are representatives of all the grade 12 students from each of the seven Catholic high schools who are going to Mass this morning, and I will be there. So we don't have the whole school going, but we have some volunteer classes going. So I want to thank Mr. Kevin Daly's two calculus classes who are representing us today, along with Miss Hayes' religion class. So we thank those students for representing us today at the graduates' mass. We will be praying for all our graduates, and again, thank those teachers for their volunteer supervision of those students today and for the students agreeing to go. We really appreciate you representing our school. And the last little fun thing I have for you is last Friday, there was a reunion, as you know, with our wall, our historical wall of distinction and our historical collage and the war memorial. We've reconnected with a lot of our graduates who love Cathedral, and the number of people who come up to me and tell me they're older now, and they say, you know, if it wasn't for Cathedral, if it wasn't for this teacher, if it wasn't, people give credit to my father who was a math teacher a long time ago. So on Friday, there was a reunion of the 1973 Junior Boys Football Championship. So if you can believe it, 50 years ago, the boys, if you look at the picture on the screen, 50 years ago, that group of boys won the junior boys championship. Now, when you go back 50 years to kids who were probably 15 or 16 at that time, unfortunately, some of those gentlemen in that picture have passed on. One of the coaches of that team, the one coach who's still with us, is Mr. Sal Ciccioli. Mr. Sal Ciccioli was the principal of Cathedral when I was the vice principal 18 years ago and was also my grade 9 phys ed teacher. He used to beat me up and stuff, but we won't mention that on the announcements. But Mr. Sal Ciccioli was there, and they... So the 1973, there they are now. They got together in Burlington. It was wonderful to see them together. And again, the number of gentlemen in that picture who said to me, if it wasn't for Cathedral, I wouldn't have had the life that I have. And they were so grateful, and it was such an honor for me to meet them. You can see there's a gentleman in the front with a Cathedral championship jacket on. The students used to always order leather jackets with a big C on the front when you won a championship. If you didn't win the championship, you didn't order the jacket. Now, the last thing these guys did was they sang an old fight song. There's an old fight song. There was, if you remember last year, we had a visitor to the school who sang the Cathedral song, which is called Blue and White, but there was kind of an informal fight song that was sung for a long, long time, probably, 70 or 80 years at games, and I don't think it's still in practice, but these gentlemen remember singing the song, so they decided to sing the song. It's like 40 seconds long, and I videotaped it, and I thought I would play it for you. So this is the old, unofficial Cathedral fight song, and there's Mr. Sal Ciccioli sitting in the front, so we'll take it away and play it. Yeah, we promised them we would play it. I'm not sure what the words are to that song, but anyways, I'm going to pass it on to Miss Simpson and the graduation committee. Have a great day, everyone.
Good morning, everyone. I have an announcement for the graduates. I have two things I want to talk to you about. First is busing on the big day, and the second thing has to do with the graduation dinner dance. So on Wednesday, June the 7th, you are all going to be expected to show up to the different events. So the first thing that we have is we have the Mass, and the Mass is going to be at St. Pat's Church on Victorian King. That starts at 9. We then have a brunch at 10:30 at the Sheraton Hotel. We then come back to the school for our rehearsal, and we have the big graduation event in the gym that evening. What I need to tell you is that you need to make your way to the church that morning by yourself. So you need to get to the church on time and in your own fashion. So either you're walking there, you're busing it, you could have somebody drop you off, or you're driving by yourself. But once the Mass is finished, we have buses booked for you. So we are going to have buses take you from the church. They're then going to take you to the Sheraton for the brunch. They're then going to take you from the Sheraton back to the school for the rehearsal. What I'm asking is that if you could please go to the bulletin board outside of the guidance office, and you can sign up for those buses. There's four sheets, so once the first sheet is filled, I'm going to ask that you go on to the second sheet and so on. So if you can do that as soon as possible, we'd like to know how many kids are going to make use of those buses. Now, the second thing I want to talk to you about is I want to talk to you about the grad dinner dance. We're selling tickets. We have been selling tickets since last Thursday. Those tickets are being sold in the guidance office during periods 3 and 4. And we're selling them until this coming Friday. Tickets are $75 for grads, $85 for the guests, and guest forms are available in the guidance office as well. Now, we have a concern, and that is we've been selling them now, and we've only sold 21 tickets. So if we keep pace with that, we might sell about 50 by Friday. We need to sell 40 tickets per day from now until Friday to have the event occur. So if I can implore you to please come as soon as you can, make sure that you bring your money. Cash is preferred, and exact cash would be great. You can also provide a check. We can't do it with debit. So periods 3 and 4 from today until Friday in the guidance office. I don't want to have to cancel this event. So thank you for listening, and I'll pass it on now to student council.
Thanks, Miss. Good morning, girls. We're here with a quick weekly council corner update, starting with our athletes of the week. The athlete of the week from the junior girls soccer team is Deborah Olutonji. Deborah is an asset to the junior girls soccer team. Deborah not only displays incredible skills on the soccer field, but she also demonstrates strong leadership skills and a positive attitude with her teammates. Deborah works hard during the team's practices and games and steps up when needed. Deborah shows strong commitment to the team even while balancing a hectic course load, including the French immersion program and playing on several sports teams, both inside and outside of school. Keep up the amazing work, Deborah. Philippe Santos is this week's other athlete of the week, a true example of a student athlete. Philippe is a strong and skilled soccer player. He plays multiple positions on the field for the junior boys soccer team. Philippe is a team player, comes early to practice, communicates in a positive manner to his teammates on and off the pitch. He's smart, dedicated, and a pleasure to coach. We're looking forward to seeing many more great things from Philippe. Keep up the great work.
Next, we want to remind all students of our upcoming Outreach Carnival happening on June 2nd. Carnival includes fun games, arts, food trucks, and new this year, an art crawl-inspired corner with booths from local shops and student-run businesses. If you are interested in having a booth, please message at Cathedral Student Council on Instagram by this Friday. We look forward to seeing you all there. And that's all from us. Now back to the desk.
Thanks, guys. Yesterday, the 2022 yearbook was distributed. If you did not pick yours up, you could get yours from the main office during your lunch. You will only receive a yearbook if you paid the $40 activity fee for the 2021-2022 school year. If you didn't pay the fee but would like to buy a yearbook, please bring payment to the main office during your lunch. 2022 graduates no longer at Cathedral can begin picking up their yearbooks starting tomorrow from the main office.
Tickets for the grad dinner dance are now on the sale until this Friday. If not enough tickets are sold, the dinner dance will be canceled, so don't delay in getting your ticket. Please buy your tickets in the guidance office during periods 3 and 4. Exact cash is appreciated.
And speaking of grads, this is an important announcement about transportation on graduation day. If you are not driving yourselves between the various events on June 7th, buses have been booked to transport grads from St. Patrick Church to the Sheraton for the brunch and then to school for the rehearsal. You must sign up for the buses so the school knows how many students will need this service. Sign-up sheets are on the grad bulletin board outside the guidance office. Thanks from Ms. Simpson.
Attention grade 12 students of African or Caribbean heritage. Youth scholarship applications are now available for the African Caribbean Cultural Potpourri Association, and packages are due before June 16th. Please visit guidance or go to their website for more info.
Attention all students going on the St. Charles trip tomorrow. Please hand in your completed permission forms to Ms. Fitzpatrick in the library today. Thank you from Ms. Fitzpatrick. And there will be a meeting today after school in room 343 for grade 11 students participating in Thursday's University of Waterloo Avogadro's chemistry contest. Thanks from Ms.
There will be a senior boys touch football practice today at 3:15 on the field. And there's a junior co-ed volleyball practice today at 3:15 in our gym. Thank you from Mr. Susie.
The junior girls soccer team worked hard in their game last night against Bishop Tonus. The team continues to improve their skills each game. The team is reminded of their practice today after school at 3:20. Thanks from Coach Rostelli.
This is a reminder for all the students who signed up for the Cathedral Tennis Team. There will be a practice today and tomorrow at 3 to 5 p.m. at the Rosedale Tennis Club. Please see Ms. Lamparski if you cannot attend. The Senior GHAC Tennis Tournament is this Thursday.
Yesterday, the girls' slow pitch team played in their league play tournament at Turner Park. After losing the first game to St. Mary's, the girls won the second game 15-11 against Bishop Tonus and then lost a close game to Bishop Ryan 13-10. The team ended league play in fourth out of 7 teams. The girls represented the school very well, played very hard with great defense and excellent hitting. The coaches and management are very proud of you. The quarterfinal game is tomorrow against 5th place St. John Henry Newman at Turner Park 3 at 10. Be at Turner Park 3 at 9:15 a.m. Thanks for Mr. Parker.
And lastly, the following classes are canceled today. Ms. Pinto, period 4 only, Ms. Daly, period 4 only, and Ms. Mundo, period 4 only.
And those are all of your announcements for today, Cathedral.
Happy birthday goes out to Maria Merlos from all your friends.
Have a great day, Gales, and thanks for watching.